In today's video, I'm gonna break down the one side hustle that actually works. If you ain't beefing about the money, then what's the problem? Yo, what is going on, guys? Paul James here. Welcome back to the channel today. I'm so excited you're here, and if you're excited to learn about this one side hustle that actually works, do me a favor and smash that like button for me right now. Also, if you're new here and you've never been here before, again, my name is Paul James, and I talk about motivation, entrepreneurship, and overall just trying to inspire you to become a better entrepreneur. So if you're into any of those things, what I'd like you to do is drop below the video right now for me, hit the subscribe button, make sure you've got notifications turned on, and then after you do that, if you actually go into the comment section and comment, "I've subscribed," I will go back through, I will read your comment, I will welcome you to the channel, because I am just so excited that you're here with us today. All right, guys, so I wanna kind of get into what this video is all about. Now, there's a big takeaway lesson from this video, and I hope that you'll walk away from this video with a different mindset at how you're approaching making money, whether it be through your business, through a side hustle, through anything really. This is gonna be something that you can use to definitely be more successful at whatever you're doing. I want you to think about first off what you're good at, because a lot of people, when they're trying to figure out what their side hustle should be or what their business should be, they're trying to think like, you know, what's gonna be the best thing that I can do that's gonna make the most money. Now, before we go that way of thinking and think about what's working, let's think about first what you're good at. Can you set up an awesome garage sale? Are you good at cooking spaghetti? Are you great at organizing? Are you an amazing Fortnite player? What are you good at? I want you to really think about it. Come up with as many things that you're good at as you can think of. In fact, show your commitment by commenting below how many things you came up with that you're good at and that you can actually do. Now, here's why I want you to do that. For some reason, as humans, we have a habit of constantly challenging ourselves by placing limits on ourselves. Now, here's what I mean by that. We constantly look at something that we want to do and we come up with reasons of why we can't do them. We might say, well, I can't do this because of this. Let me give you an example. Let's say you want to start a Fortnite YouTube channel and you're good at playing the game, you've got a streaming setup, but you come up with something in your head that stops you from doing it. Maybe it's, I can't start a Fortnite YouTube channel because I don't have 100,000 subscribers like so-and-so does. Okay, so we come up with these limiting beliefs in our head, and successful people actually knock these barriers down. And I'm gonna explain to you why thinking about what you can do is a lot better than thinking about what you can't do. You know, when I was 10 years old, there was probably a lot of things that I couldn't do as a 10-year-old, even if I wanted to make some money. Like, I probably couldn't have went out there and got a job as an office manager. I probably couldn't have become a salesman or a firefighter or a police officer, right, because I was 10 years old. But you know what I could do? And what I actually did, I actually went and I set up like a table at the end of my dad's driveway one day during the weekend. And I started putting out all the stuff on the table and putting price tags on it that I thought was valuable of stuff that I owned. You know, just random things. I was just a kid. But my point is that I was out there doing what I could do. And I knew that maybe I could sell some of these things. Maybe someone else would drive down through the neighborhood and see one of these things laying out and want one, and I could make some money. And I did actually make some money at it. I don't know if it was neighbors who felt sorry for me and just came over and bought some stuff. But my point is that you always have to do whatever it is that you can do. I wanna give you another analogy that'll maybe really hit home for people out there. Because I know a lot of people are into like Shopify and drop shipping, and there's a lot of barriers to entry with that business, I guess you could say. There's technical challenges that come into play. And just overall, like setting up the store and knowing how to do all that, as a beginner, can be kind of a daunting task. So let me give you another analogy that maybe you can relate to. So let's say that you wanted to set up a Shopify store and that was the business you wanted to pursue. You wanted to become a millionaire drop shipper. But what's standing in your way? Well, you don't know how to set up a Shopify store. You believe that you don't have the technical ability or know-how to actually get that in place. So what could you do? Well, what a lot of people do is they just sit around saying to themselves, well, I don't know how to set up a Shopify store, so I can't do this. Again, we need to crush those limiting beliefs and start looking at what we can do. So your number one option obviously could be to like go on YouTube and start learning about how to set up a Shopify store. You know, watching tutorials about how to open a store and how to like set pricing and how to set shipping and all that stuff, right? That could be your number one. But let's break it down even more basic. Let's crush the excuses even further. What could you do as a second option? Realistically, guys, you could start a dropshipping business with nothing more than a sheet of paper, like a flyer. Think about like an event that you're going to. Maybe it's like a church get together or a family reunion or some kind of gathering with like maybe a group or friends or something like that that you're going to. What I mean is like a group of people that you can kind of tap into that are all gonna be in the same place at the same time. Now, I want you to go onto AliExpress and find something cool that you think this group of people would be interested in, much like you would do with dropshipping. Pick out an item, take a picture of it, put it on the flyer, the piece of paper, with what it is. Make sure it's a really like innovative product that they're gonna be really into. And when you go to your get together, start passing around the sheet of paper and telling people about it and name your price. Again, it's just like a really simple analogy of how no matter what is standing in your way, there's always something that you can do to take action on to actually make something work. So do what you can, figure out what you can't do later on. A lot of us get stuck in this analysis paralysis, right? Where we're constantly learning, we're constantly trying to educate ourselves, but we're never actually taking any action. So I want you to challenge yourself today to take action on what you know right now. And then as you start to get success with that, it's gonna snowball. You're gonna be able to pick up on other things and figure other things out as you go. It really is a lot more simple than people make it out to be, and people really overcomplicate it. And if you're sitting there thinking like you're the only one that overcomplicates things, you're not. We all do it. I've done it. Everyone does it. And I really wanted to make this video to help give you some stories and metaphors to help you really kind of think past that and break through that barrier and hopefully like give you that aha moment, like, okay, I see where he's coming at with this. I need to think about things differently and approach my side hustle or my business differently. So here's another interesting story for you. I spent several months down in Florida for the winter, something I do pretty often because I just don't like the cold. So I go somewhere warmer for winter. Now, you know that down in Florida, the theme parks are really big, down in Orlando specifically. The theme parks are massive. You've got Universal, you've got Disney World. Disney World alone has four different parks. Now, Disney World has this thing called pin traders. And what it is they sell pins. They're like collectible pins that you can like put on your shirt. And they sell like a little strap that you can actually put the pins on. And they have these stands and they have people walking around called pin traders. And what it basically is it's a chance for people, kids, adults even do it. They walk around with their pins, and if they see an employee working at Disney World or if they go into the pin trader store and they see someone there who's also wearing one of the little things around their neck with the pins on it and they see one that they like, they can trade them for their pin. So they don't have to purchase another one. They can literally just take the pin off and then trade it. Now people really get into this. I don't know if it's because it's like a collectible thing or it's just fun for people, but they really, really get into it. So every weekend we'd head out to the parks, and specifically one park in general when we would head to called Epcot. It's the one with the giant silver ball. We'd walk in the door and over on the side, there would just be some random people set up on a like a table, like one of the tables you'd eat at. These weren't employees, these were just regular everyday people that were there. And what they were doing was they brought a big binder full of these pins that were inside. They must have been collecting them or maybe buying them on eBay. I'm not really sure. But what they were doing was they were actually having people come and look at their pin collection, and then they were selling the pins to the people who would come and see them. You know, people would look and see, oh, I really like that one. That's one I haven't seen or that Disney World doesn't offer. And then they would buy it from them. Now, this might not be the best business model, and I'm not saying that Disney even approves of this or that you should go do that, but it's just another story that I thought would maybe help inspire you and motivate you and help knock down those excuses, knock down those barriers, help you think past what you can't do and really tap into what you can do right now, because there is something that you have in your arsenal that you can do right now and that you're not acting on and that you should be. So the moral of this whole video and that the takeaway I want you to get away from it is that the one side hustle that actually works is gonna be the one that you're gonna commit to right now today and get out there and do. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and of course subscribe and make sure you've got notifications turned on. Until next time, guys, I am Paul James. Peace out.